You were there overnight in the eye of the storm. What was that like, Barbara?
It was pretty horrific. I mean, I've been through many cyclones over the 30 years I've been reporting in the Pacific, but this was by far the worst. In fact, this whole concrete structure was shaking, and it just sounded like this screaming freight train outside. It was absolutely horrific. And the thing that struck me was I'm in a safe building, and if it's like this here, what is it like for all those tens of thousands of people who are not so safe?
Now, I know there's been a curfew imposed, but have you managed to get out and see what the situation is like?
Yes, the curfew's just actually been lifted, and I've just had a quick look around the area I'm in. It's just roofing iron everywhere, and I think, you know, really that's the most disturbing thing, because that roofing iron has come from homes, and we are seeing reports of widespread devastation with homes and worse reports. But because it's all on social media, until we actually get it confirmed, it's one of those things you really don't want to sort of fuel fan the flames. However, I can tell you it's pretty bad out there. The real test of a cyclone is coconut trees. They're so hardy, and if they're stripped bare, you know you've got a problem, and that's what Tonga's facing today.
That's dreadful. And is there any power? I mean, the power was out overnight.
That's right. They switched the power off last night around 8 o'clock as a prevention safety measure. And also the water's out, so there's no water in Tongatapu. We do know that it is Tongatapu that has been hit the worst. Other islands like Babao seem to have escaped the worst, but it is Tongatapu which has received the king hit. Surprisingly, mobile services are still up. How, I have no idea, but it says a lot about technology.
Amazing. Thank you so much for your time this morning, Barbara Dreaver.